Hello and welcome to Newsclick. I am Sumedha and we're bringing you the glimpse of some of the most important stories that we report about at Newsclick. Amidst the rising atrocities against the Dalit community in India and the political climate in general, a statue of Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar was removed from a Bhopal court on Sunday. The statue has been reportedly removed by unknown assailants. The incident took place after District Court Judge Rajendra Verma had objected to the installation of the statue in the court's premises. The statue was taken down hours before it was supposed to be unveiled. The judge asked the association to not unveil the statue as it did not have permission from the Madhya Pradesh High Court. Senior advocate and the executive member of the Bhopal District Bar Association, Ambika Soni, said that the caste issue seems to have played a major role in this controversy. She said that a group of upper caste lawyers disagreed with the installation of the statue. When they could not stop the installation, they decided to complain to the judge. Delhi's factories have become a hellhole for its workers. A 24-year-old worker succumbed to his death in New Delhi's Swarupnagar area. In another instance, a young worker experienced serious burn injuries after a helmet manufacturing unit caught fire. Delhi's factories are emerging to be hellhole for its workers, engulfing them in fires one instance after the other, primarily due to the lack of safety measures. In January this year, 17 people were charred to death as fire broke out in the Bhavana industrial area. This included several women and another pregnant woman. As per the figures available, 28 workers have already succumbed to factory fires until April this year. There is more data that has not been recorded. That happens primarily because of the negligence of the administration. With the government outrightly ignoring the workers, there are no safety measures for them. The factories that they work in often come under unauthorized areas. Given the treatment meted out to the workers, 10 central unions have given a call for national strike on the 8th and 9th of January 2019. The strike aims to raise issues about the wages, about the security of the workers, amongst other things. The state governments of India have yet again failed to identify the actual number of manual scavengers. The latest results of the national survey have managed to find only 25,000 manual scavengers across 170 districts of the country. Criticizing the survey, Bezwara Wilson of the Safai Karamchari Andolan said that there are multiple discrepancies in this kind of surveys. The actual figures of the manual scavengers could be at least 3 times higher than the results that have come out. The survey camps were held in multiple district quarters. The manual scavengers were asked to come to these camps and enroll themselves. However, there were problems with these kind of camps. The manual scavengers had to come and enroll themselves, but these camps were there only for a short period of time. And sometimes, the information about the camps could not reach the manual scavengers. The results of the survey also excluded those who were involved in other hazardous forms of manual scavenging, such as the cleaning of septic tanks and other sewers. The repeated attempt at these kind of surveys appear to be extremely flawed and go on to show the lack of political will on the part of the government. The opposition against the sentencing of 6 trade union leaders by a municipal court in Phnom Penh continuously grows. A joint statement by 95 civil society activists from across Cambodia is gaining momentum. The court's ruling is being viewed as politically coloured in nature, with the government's repression of opposition groups as well as trade union activities. Earlier in November this year, Prime Minister Hun Sen had directed the courts to do away with long-drawn cases. These cases primarily related to the trade union leaders as well as those who were associated with the 2013 and 2014 protests in the region. When one considers the government's long-standing history of being wary of any opposition, this statement comes as a greater surprise. Ever since the landslide sweep of the Cambodian People's Party under the leadership of Sen in July this year, the government seems to have taken an ambivalent stand against its biggest opposition, which is the trade unions. That's all that we have for you today on this episode of the Daily Roundup. To follow these stories and many more, log on to our website www.newsclick.in. Also follow us on Facebook and subscribe to us on YouTube.